Yeah, greetings. Firstly, I would like to say thanks to all the people in the world, really, that support reggae music. And I don't think you fully understand, like the people here fully understand what young artists in Jamaica go through to make it here. Understand? You hear what I say? To make it here. So it's a valuable thing for youths in Jamaica. It's not just to make money, but just to be somebody that, you understand? To come out of a country that is actually downtrodden and people are, you know, afraid of a lot of stuff. You know what I mean? And this is not something that is like it happened today and it's gone tomorrow or is a periodic thing. This is something that is every day. So in Jamaica right now, you have a young soldier who is probably not even playing a guitar. You understand? He's probably just walking up and down on the road and just singing out loud. And in the back of his mind, he must say, one day, I have to be on a festival in Rotterdam, Sunsplash. You understand? That is not, it's not a joke. It's a reality. And that is the pain of Joe Altinunez, of Jehovah Evil. See me? By extension. Joe Altinunez is a youth where he just walk up and down in a hot sun every single day, to and fro. He don't have a dollar, but he's going to find a studio and he's going to find a song that you are going to listen to. See what I'm saying? Because that's what it's all about. That's what the system has put into us. It's not about quality, it's about making hits. Music is not about making hits. Music is about freeing your soul. You understand? Music is about knowing what I have been experiencing and connecting to it. Because you obviously, anybody experience stress, pain, all kind of different things. See? So music is that vehicle that Jah give to share this expression and not in a doldrum, in a wonderful form, in a form where we can dance and feel good together and get rid of everything we name separation. Music is not made for hit making. Is a little youth. Basically, I grew up in that yard scene. I was in a group with the twins and Joe when we were like 13 years old. Joe was like probably about 6 or 7 at that time. And the group was called Encore at that time. Joe was like the magic in the group. We all could sing, but Joe, when he sang, the people felt something different. You understand? He always was in the back. We had to always be pulling him to the front, you know, pulling him to the front because he was so shy. And he was so small at that time. But we used to perform everywhere, you know, from hotels to everywhere, just to, you know, to have a life as musicians. And at that time, we were very young, extremely young. And we grew into it and grew into it. But Joe always had a burning thing inside of him that him going to be out there on the world stage. All of us, me personally, John and Aija even as well, used to just do music like Infinite. It was a part of the pantomime in Jamaica. He's an actor as well. So we all had different roads. I used to do law. Different roads, the whole way I take. So I'm going to say,
But this youth are always depending, like you must say, my youth in our ways. Right now, we're too talented for just a run up and down behind people. And just music, my dear. He was the only one who was doing music, like 94-7, no doubt. The only one. As you say, up and down, Burning Sun Studio. Gavin Blair, we have a big up Equinox Music as well. Equinox Music was instrumental in making sure that that youth did actually have a platform. You understand? Something where it could be respected. I mean, as I said, you're viewed upon as a hit. So if you don't make a hit, you might be respected by your peers or by one or two people that are real connoisseurs of music or are music lovers to the core. You might be respected because they see quality. But the world of music and the business of music does not respect quality. It does not respect the spirituality that music brings, the heart that music brings. And that is why that youth is not here. He should be here. He should be here.
Tradition of 10 and a half First Avenue in Vineyard Town. Maybe you can explain.